The sports world was abuzz in early 2016 regarding a eulogy given by Coach Monty Williams, assistant basketball coach for Oklahoma City. His wife, Ingrid, had died in an accident. They had five children, and three of the children were with him on that tragic day. A woman named Savannah Donaldson was driving a car, and it was found out later she had meth in her system, and they hit on it about 78 miles per hour. They both died, Savannah at the scene, and later on Ingrid. And so Monty gave a powerful eulogy at his wife's funeral, and it went all viral over the sports world. And I'd like people to take a look at this very powerful eulogy from Coach Monty Williams.
Now, I'm going to close with this, and I think it's the most important thing that we need to understand. Everybody's praying for me and my family, which is right. But let us not forget that there were two people in this situation, and that family needs prayer as well. And we have no ill will towards that family. In my house, we have a sign that says, "As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord." We cannot serve the Lord if we don't have a heart of forgiveness. That family didn't wake up wanting to hurt my wife. Life is hard. It is very hard. And that was tough. But we hold no ill will towards the Donaldson family. And we, as a group, brothers united in unity, should be praying for that family because they grieve as well. So let's not lose sight of what's important. God will work this out. My wife is in heaven. God loves us. God is love. And when we walk away from this place today, let's celebrate, because my wife is where we all need to be. And I'm envious of that. But I got five crumb snatchers I got to deal with. I love you guys for taking time out of your day to celebrate my wife. We didn't lose her. When you lose something, you can't find it. I know exactly where my wife is. I'll miss holding her hand. I'll miss talking with my wife. Sam and Coach Donovan probably couldn't figure out why I always wanted to get out of the office, me and Mo Cheeks. Mo probably wanted to go do something else, but we always wanted to get out of the office. I just enjoy being with my wife. I enjoy being with my family. And most of the times we didn't do anything. We'd just be at the house sitting around doing nothing. I'm gonna miss that. Let's not lose sight of what's important. God is important. What Christ did on the cross is important. Let's not lose sight of that family that also lost someone that they love. I love you guys. I hope I get a chance to hug and shake a hand and give a kiss on the cheek. But let's keep what's important at the forefront. Thank you.
Well, the question we ask is, how did Monty Williams get to that point? Was it the luck of the draw? Was it in his DNA? Was it maybe saying extra prayers? I think one would understand the depth of his faith by being one thing, a disciple that has been formed and shaped through formation. And sometimes for us as Catholics, we treat formation as classes, whether people have the time to attend a class or not. And they reach a point where they say, well, we've reached this level, all the sacraments are done, and there's not much more to learn about other than to live the life. Formation, as Luke tells us in his gospel, is on the journey with Jesus to Jerusalem, and his disciples are formed along the way on the journey. Formation does involve maybe some classes, some reading, listening to podcasts, living out the faith in searching from the littlest child to the oldest adult. We never arrive. We constantly learn and keep growing. I know for Coach Monty Williams, he has to be living that ongoing. And what a difficult challenge of raising five children by yourself now. And that changes your life. But yet to have that deep faith, as Coach Monty Williams says, "As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord." So when we leave the house, are the decisions we're making one that pleases God, that serves the Lord and says, this household places Jesus first in our life? Can only be accomplished through formation. And St. Patrick's offers many ways and many styles of reaching out people, informing hearts, minds, spiritual lives into the image of Jesus in our faith.
It used to be that my entire sense of what it was to be Catholic revolved around going to Mass on a Sunday and coming home again. And then next week, coming back and going to Mass again and coming home again. And in between times, that was where my real life happened. It's because I sought out experiences of formation that everything about my faith life changed. It's because I happened upon some experiences that turned on the lights inside of me that said, oh my gosh, that's what we do? Ooh, this is how I can improve and grow in my personhood. It's because of all of the formative experiences that I've been lucky enough to have, of all of the different kinds.
Formation means intentionally staying active and seeking out newness in my faith. My wife finished the RCIA class here at St. Pat's, and I found it incredibly inspiring. And because of her experience, I joined Just Faith here at St. Pat's. And I'm more active and aware and participating in my church now.
I was initially forced into coming to Life Teen, but after I started going, there was something there that was keeping me going voluntarily every Sunday, and that I believe is the community there. You do see Christ and other people there, and then your relationships are so centered in Christ, unlike many of the relationships you have in other places.
The thing I like about it is when you usually go to church, you're just there, you just serve Mass, do the normal stuff. When you're in Ed, you actually understand what you're doing. And I don't feel like alone because my friends are also doing the same thing. So I feel like I'm not alone when I'm praying the rosary or I'm praying at night or stuff like that. So normally at Edge, we usually have some games, some activities. We usually like write on paper or present. I like the skits. It breaks open the scripture into life, not just in the book. And I like how there's always something different every day. It's not the same usual routine. There's always some surprises with Kevin and Becky and all that.
The formation programs for my children here at St. Patrick's have been wonderful for our family. They've helped us teach our children the lessons of the Bible in their own words and in the atrium with a hands-on experience. It's wonderful. And then moving on to Stepping Stones, where they grow their community and their circle of friends, meeting kids from other schools. It's learning the same stories, but in a little different way, each step of the way through all of the programming here. We've had fabulous experiences, and the community is so welcoming for everyone who's interested.
St. Patrick's is such an amazing place. We have so many different types of formations that are available to simply to everybody. So I don't know how it is that somebody wouldn't find exactly what's right for them. I find myself always thinking, why wouldn't somebody choose something this year? And I find myself this year wanting to ask everybody, what will you choose?